Eric, I knew something was wrong with your phone. How you doing, bud?
Hey, Ricky!
It's good to see you.
Yeah, man.
Come on.
Hey,
you're not wearing your dress. You look odd.
Well, I'm not. NSW, what are you doing here, man, in St. Catharines?
I found you. Little hide and go seek between some boys, you know?
Yeah, man. Oh, you found me. That's great.
A good one.
What's up?
So, you know, NSW, I think we both did pretty good on the last one. I think it's about time we go after those space pirates. Come on! We're like 6 leads ahead of these guys. Come on, let's get in there. What do you think?
Did you
tag titles for your tummy?
Did you win your match?
Yeah. I did great. How'd you do?
I lost, Ricky. I lost again. Okay? Alright? I pinned Scotty O'Shea.
Congrats.
I pinned Mike Forte.
Congrats.
And then I lost.
Yeah.
Okay? I lost to John Atlas.
I think the big problem is
and
I
where were you?
I think that's the big problem. I wasn't there. I think that would have helped and we would have cinched that third one.
Would it? Or would you just throw in the towel?
I understand, Eric. You know, I don't want to get into a whole thing with you, man. I try to protect you. I didn't want to see anything bad happen to you. I actually think that we can do real good around here. I actually think we could be tag team champions. I'm not saying you can't be the heavyweight champion. Of course you can, but you got your brain scrambled a little last time.
Yeah, I know. Del Bruno had me. I know you were just trying to look out for me, man. I get it. But you know what? I don't know right now. I got to get this dress off. I need a win. I think I just got to take a break, man. I think I just got to step away from the next show. I don't know, man. I don't know.
Eric, we can win.
We'll see, man. We'll see.
Call me.
The following contest is for number one contendership for the NSW Women's Championship.
Carl Davenport, you're just egging me on now, aren't you?
Oh, we're
third
back.
Week in a row, you got this damn shirt on.
Introducing first.
What the hell, dude?
Ontario.
Man, you know what? We're getting into fall, okay? The sun is not out as much. But speaking of shining a light on the competition here at New School Wrestling, we are coming off the Women's Grand Prix with a very impressive outing by one of my personal favorites, Shiloh.
A rematch from the Grand Prix of the semifinals.
That's
and
what this is. Now, do
your
you
pick,
use any influence on
your,
that? Because
no,
you were not happy that Crystal Moon.
But your pick versus my pick, your pick won at Women's Grand Prix. Tonight might be a whole different story. Because if you remember, at the Women's Grand Prix, Shiloh got a bye in the very first round.
Absolutely.
After Crystal Moon and had a tough contest. The situation,
yeah,
the circumstances
raise,
are a little different.
You
now.
Raise a very good point. And I don't like saying that you have a lot of validity, but you do in this case.
Both these women are fresh. Both these women are vying for the number one contendership to the newly minted NSW Women's Championship. And you know what? I will give your lady Shiloh. I'll give her a little something. Oh, you know what? She just did the whole scream into the canvas. You remember what happened at the Grand Prix?
Oh yeah.
Shiloh took advantage of that. She didn't do it this time.
She's waiting.
She did not do it.
But again, if you did the same thing, that's leading Crystal Moon on to think that you're just going to rehash the same
it could.
Tactics.
But I will give Shiloh this. I was on the bandwagon that Shiloh should have got the first shot at CC Muff.
Okay.
CC
Muff.
I was
respect.
On that boat.
That's respect right
I
there.
I was on that boat. That the person that was defeated in the finals, I was on that boat. But
right.
NSW did say, no, we're going to have this match to determine the new number one contender.
Now, would it be going out on a limb to say that Shiloh might have gained some respect for Crystal Moon after that match on the show?
That's hard to say. That is very, very hard to say, but... Oh, interesting attempt to get out of there. Kind of used a fish hook type maneuver there.
Well, if Shiloh has to do it all, she will. She's
for
more
sure.
than capable.
All right, our ringer friend, Crystal Moon, trying to bring Shiloh down. Shiloh State keeping her vertical base.
Crystal should have locked that in a little more pressure.
Perhaps. Oh, Able to avoid the elbow. Oh, able to avoid it again. Third time's in face. But oh! I thought perhaps Crystal Moon had gained a headlock, but it looks like Shiloh was. That was part of Shiloh's plan the whole time.
You gotta be liking that, Matt.
I was liking that.
Yeah! Oh. Come on! Serious? Let's go!
Crystal Moon just called Shiloh over. Shiloh obliged. What do we got going here? Oh! A spear from Crystal Moon. One, two. Crystal Moon able to obtain a two count, but it's a three to need.
That came almost too close for Milo.
Crystal Moon getting ready. Charging in. Oh, a kick from Shiloh. Oh, the top of Crystal Moon's head coming in contact with that turnbuckle.
Just clipped it like part two.
And sometimes that's even worse than hitting it flush. One, two.
Come on, ref, that could have been a three had the referee been right on the ball with that.
Come on.
Do you know sometimes Shiloh's like a predator, right? She really just kind of saunts over, but in the saunting is stalking at the same time.
Very cerebral, takes her time, thinks things out, doesn't rush in very often. Doesn't panic. One thing I would never say about Shiloh is that she panics in that ring. Very meticulous.
Yep. Love the way you said that about the panic.
Oh, leg drop. Shiloh bootlegs.
And we know Crystal Moon likes the leg drop. She
does.
That
she does, for sure.
But on the receiving end, maybe not so much. But we'll see. We'll see how Crystal Moon, if at all she can rally against Shiloh.
Shiloh taking the corner. A reversal in the middle. Here comes Crystal Moon. Oh, missing Shiloh. Shiloh comes in.
Oh,
glancing forearm.
Man, did Crystal Moon's nose
just collapsed. What does Shiloh have planned here?
Don't do it. Oh, no. Say it.
Oh,
no, Crystal. What are you
going to
do now?
Oh! And that could be it. Forget from Shiloh.
Forget Crystal Moon.
But Crystal Moon kicked out.
Man, you cannot eclipse Crystal Moon.
Crystal Moon kicked out after that massive elbow drop.
I really thought, man, that was it. Like I said, I thought you were just going to eclipse Crystal Moon. Just use my same line again. Oh, these fans, come on.
Oh, these fans. Oh, chin breaker.
Oh, not to Shiloh's face. Come on, Crystal. Man, Shiloh's still giving her 2 cents, but she ate an arm from Crystal Moon on that one.
Crystal Moon missing again. Oh, went for that forearm again. Crystal Moon picking up the speed.
Too smart this time.
Splash in the corner. Oh, tripping up Shiloh. Here comes Crystal Moon. Double knee in the corner.
That'll disable the arms, albeit temporarily. And if you could get her from prevent her from getting those shoulder up for the three.
Over the pinfall. One, two. Shiloh rolling that shoulder. Able to avoid the three count.
Come on, Shiloh.
Crystal Moon perhaps getting a
little
bit frustrated.
Shiloh looked a little bit worried on that. Not panicking, mind you.
No,
worried.
Not panicking.
Oh, very precise wording in there.
Forearm shivers from Crystal Moon. Oh!
Seems like Crystal Moon tries to go for the forearms when
she
it knows.
She went to the eyes there. One, two, three.
Oh!
Shiloh!
Shiloh got her for the roll-up.
Here's your winner and number one contender by SW Women's Championship, Shiloh!
Well, there we
Kyle
go.
Davenport.
As if there was any doubt, Matt.
Kyle
Terry.
Davenport, I am not going to claim that Shiloh does not deserve to be number one contender.
Hard-fought victory.
Hard-fought victory, perhaps.
And a beautiful, clean
finish for
Shiloh on that. You saw the referee, his ass got down. He knocked the bottom rope. That's why the bottom rope was shaking during that three count.
Well, okay, but you know what? The bottom rope wasn't even shaking. Why? Because both of Crystal Moon's feet were on there. She had rolled her up so much that both of her feet were on the bottom rope.
So that rope was moving near her feet.
It was moving very slowly because her feet were bobbing up and down.
Oh, sure.
Listen, I'm not saying Shiloh doesn't deserve to be the number one contender, but there was so many things wrong with that, including the fact that the referee's face was a mere 3 inches away from those 2 feet.
You're with your baby.